I got the party going up. A champ with the crown is here. I'ma win anywhere. Hey, so shake it like you don't care. I shake it up everywhere. And I can bake cakes by the pound. Blow the whistle cause I love that sound. And we can just keep going round. I'm ready for another round.
Go ahead, touch down like that. 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 Hey, go ahead, touch down like that. Go ahead, touch down like that. Go ahead, touch down like that. Go ahead, touch down like that.
Like a transport, and I ain't never seen something so round. How round? Round like a planet in orbit. Round like a b-ball, 23 Jordan. Dunking on default, automatic forces attract me to females. I look this gorgeous. How did you even come in existence? Hey, how did you just appear out in an instance? You got me all driven, revving my pistons. I wonder if she like the stick shift. Hey, count it four and make a wish.
Wish.
I wish.
What?
That shorty keep it lit. Cause if I shoot my shot, I won't miss. No backboard, gotta sound a light swish.
Go ahead, touch down like that. 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 Hey, go ahead, touch down like that. 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 Like
work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the.
That's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
down for that. Time I was down and out, had to bring grinding back. Doing the drills and working the wheel where you're grinding at. You know what it be, playing this here for the keeps. Had to make out with a feast, a family to feed. Third call where the trophy should be. EA got me in the game now. Read on with the gang now. They're here with a lane now. My home second with a rain now. Legendary on the field, kind of drip is a skill, it's the highest cause of bill, ain't nothing just to heal.
A habit, you should know it's automated. I've been getting to it, I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chick, she don't know the occupation. I just wanna know that I can hold a conversation. Oof, I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you, now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check, trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put $100 of savings in. I can tell now that you ain't talking about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down from. I'm gonna pull it with the bar down one. 6 months saying I ain't once. Trying to tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She said she ain't trying to deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that seat. Ooh, and she felt intrigued.
It is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. Two teams here, each off to 1-0 starts as this one is underway on EA Sports. And this carries into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, normally you see three tight ends in a formation. You have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run. And I know as a safety, when I saw that,
I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. It's a six-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got six, now second and four. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
No gain on the play, and it brings up third down.
They'll look to throw here. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. They are in a zone. Remember, folks, four interceptions for this defense a week ago. First drive, make it number five.
And the focal point will be the people who pick the ball out of the air. But let's not forget, to make that happen, it has to be an excellent pass rush, terrific coverage where they are plastered to the receivers, and then, of course, taking it away, making the catch, and going in the other direction.
That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
And inches at the Panthers' 47-yard line.
Take it down shy to 45 at the 46. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans. They go play fake. Mahomes. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Mahomes firing complete. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Looking for McLaurin, but this is intercepted. Turnover bug last week, three interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on some change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. And they give this time to the tailback. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be third and six upcoming.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. D4 with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven.
Three and out.
On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on the punt. Punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Taken to the 37. Not good at all. Punted just 24 yards there. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
How about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves, maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
On first down, Mahomes. That's complete to his receiver, McCoy. Inside the 25. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And down inside the 15 he goes. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they get to that end zone real fast.
It's caught, and he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
That's another thing.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And it's good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead.
Saints 7, Panthers nothing.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
Well, there's times when you see these catches that are made, and we just know the guys playing it are really wishing for college rules. Only need that one foot down instead of two. It's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a 3rd and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he finally goes out of bounds across the opposite 40. A big third down play there for the Panthers. 41 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. From the shotgun now, here's an inside game. And he'll go down at the 28. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. scrimmage. Nothing there for him. Second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. The 40. The 20. 10.
Right down the
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
And it's good to make it 14-0.
Makes the score Saints 14, Panthers nothing. Will Lutz to kick off.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20.
Taken down.
Up to make the tackle, J.C. Jackson. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Complete.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Just a 25-yard punt. Not what he was hoping for by any stretch. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here, 1st and 10. Mahomes now on 1st down. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
And 4 at the 40.
A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this 2nd week of the regular season. He's got a 1st down and more inside the 30. Touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
19-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3-and-out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive, you're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get this one up to the 26.
Carried by number 26.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They'll try and throw for it here. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. No gain on the play there, second down.
Second and 10.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
16 yards.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. They'll throw now on the final play. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. And a short kick taking it about the 16. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 33-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down. Stopped at the Panthers 37. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium, because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
At the Panthers.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Working from the gun, Mahomes into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 20-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second-half blowout material.
And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because
And he's got it! Touchdown, Saints! Irv Smith Jr., his second touchdown on the season. And the Saints add on to their lead. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him.
In this position, trying to get back into the game. Teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to lose yardage here back at the 8. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
You've got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Back to throw here. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say,
and he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
They just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. And he'll try and hurry the kick, gets it away, but it's not looking that great. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Mahomes now on first down. Short throw to Smith. Inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards there, good for a Saints first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. For 17 yards out, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. What a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, and he's got him in the lead. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Throw left sideline here is complete. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and 5. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. He's going to look deep down the field. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Here's Matt Bosher now as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive.
Here's Mahomes to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. Open man is Anderson. Pass the 20. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That goes as a gain of 36 on third down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they'll take this one inside the 10 down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
3 yard pickup brings up second and 7.
On play action, it's Mahomes. He'll buy some time right. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. From 8 yards out, and the Saints are pouring it on. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
Lutz now to kick this one away.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
At the 20-yard line.
Play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Looking deep downfield. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
On play action, they'll throw. And he's taken down here by the Saints.
We've been around this league for a while. Many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. It's incomplete. And the Panthers turned away on fourth down. And now the football's going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Smith catches left side. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Saints just continue to roll. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, are they going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
And it's third down.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. We'll call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
3 plays and out. It's fourth down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. He'll look to throw. He throws, and this is going to be incomplete. And the Panthers turned away on fourth down. And the Saints are going to get it back and in great shape.
It's a turnover on downs.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up second and goal.
So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they're going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Looking like they're well on their way to a 2-0 start. All smiles right now on that sideline, isn't it?
As well there should be. It's hard to win a game in the NFL. We hear it all the time. We know that it's difficult. But guess who's smiling? But inside is thinking 24-hour rule because we're going to have to play again next week.
Boss man.
Oh, without a doubt. The head coach, he wants him to feel good, but at the same time, find a way to keep improving.
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
And 5 yards to go.
Out of the gun now on third down. He's going to let it fly. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Gary and Conley. And now off to the races down the right side.
Just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Takes this about 5 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this?
Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9.
A defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
He's got his man complete. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line.
To number 89.
That goes for a gain of 31. And the big play pushes him all the way out to the 40 now for first down. Incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Jay Hawkinson, incomplete. Brings up second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by John Johnson. This one, a victory here for New Orleans. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for New Orleans, they used a favorable early schedule to their advantage as they move to 2-0. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Seattle Seahawks come to town. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at Soldier Field with the Chicago Bears. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.